Morning, one and all, and howdy. This is ever-loving Ira Fosberg coming to you over KYOL 1000 watts of power in Benteen, entertaining all of Schuyler County. Well, it's a beautiful morning in the Big Sky Country, the first day of autumn, September 22nd. And remember, 1934 is a very good year. Slogan courtesy of the Benteen Sons of the Open Range, who'll hold their weekly meeting at the Grange Hall this Friday night.
Once I built a railroad, I made it run, made it race against time. Once I built a railroad, now it's done. Brother, can you spare a dime? Once I built a tower.
Car's coming. Major Hart lines by the looks of it.
Elroy? What can I do for you?
Nothing. Major told me to deliver this. I tried to get out of bringing it.
Take a meal with us?
No thanks, Shasta.
It's how you feel that way, Elroy. Looks like an invite. Elroy Bones is still dead against us.
Major Roland Hartline requests the pleasure of your company, dinner and dancing, Sunday evening.
Did you mention of me in there?
You know the Major's rules. No Indians, Mexicans, or college graduates allowed.
Well, I call it strange. I wonder what he wants.
Maybe he wants to make peace.
You better go and find out. You got something to wear?
You'll see.
You know what to do with these things?
I'll bet she knows.
Colonel Dahlgren, honored guests, and friends. This can be, and with God's help will be, America's century. Our country, despite a temporary spell of economic depression and an upsurge in cynicism and debunking, will weather the moral and spiritual crisis. I rise to declare my faith in the future, our future of consolidation, cooperation, and recovery, and to ask your help and sacrifice in making us strong and great once again. I offer a toast to tradition, to the heritage I serve and the values we share and that bind us together. I call upon that great spirit of adventure which carried us to victory in foreign wars and the individual enterprise which has made our great western desert bloom like the rose. For above all, America is a promise. Toast with me then, America. America, the beautiful.
Mrs. Shasta, I'm Ann Klinger, Major Hotline's guest for the weekend, and I have heard that you actually help your husband run your little ranch. I mean, you know, running the cattle and all, and grooming baby cattle.
The strongest oats must fall. The sweet things in life.
Shasta?
Major, Major, I'm curious. Why'd you invite us here?
Enjoy your drinks. We'll talk later.
That lady wouldn't stop talking.
Pay for your dinner around here one way or the other. I was just asking the old guy why we...
Mr. Shasta, I think you're escorting the most beautiful woman at the ball. Can a beat-up old cabberman steal a dance?
Sure. Sure, I'll keep watching. In case I get the hang of it, I'll cut in.
The strongest old must fall. How can you do? what you've never owned. Life is just a bowl of cherries. So live and laugh at it all.
You should put on a party dress more than once a year, Mrs. Shasta. Seems a pure waste to make a cowhand out of you.
Why? It's no shame for a woman.
As the school teacher, maybe, but you deserve a lot more than living poor and making do.
You don't understand, Major. I love my husband. I enjoy my life.
Don't let the sociability fool you. I want to talk business.
Go ahead.
My people have had the oak leaf since the 70s. It's a long time. We've held out against blizzards, droughts, thieves, screwworm, cattle companies, feederlots, and bank panics. Kept our own and taken care of our own. The oak leaf stands for something.
So does the Triple S. Stands for us.
You're a fair enough cattleman, Shasta, but these days you can't make it without capital. Money. I'll give you a bonus. 5%. No, I guess I can make it 7.5% of the profits.
What profits, Midget? You're gonna have trouble selling off that scraggly herd you got.
You'll never see an offer like this again. I'm giving you a chance for once to ride with the winner.
Major, I work for myself.
You're ungrateful.
For what?
Now listen, no half-breed married to a white woman who'd have been better off married to her own kind is gonna get rich off me. You'll scrounge. I'll see to it.
I've got a place in this country.
And I'll put you in it.
I hope it doesn't come to that, Major. Thanks for the invite.
Would you excuse us, please? Thank you.
Quiet.
You want to dance?
You had a fight with Hartline.
Nah, it wasn't much of a fight. He offered me a job, actually. Can you imagine me as somebody else's foreman in 20 years? He must figure I'm a pretty good old boy for a half-breed, though.
He knows how good you really are.
No, he's running his place into the dirt, and I guess he just needs somebody to bail him out. The words were choking him.
Glad you said no.
On the other hand, took his wages for years, and maybe I owe him some.
You don't owe him anything. You're making something special for us. He'd never understand.